Hi there, and welcome to another set of meditations on the philosophy of Stoicism. I have a two-part meditation here for you. This week, we're going to be talking about time. Time as a tool for us to help us live our best life. It might seem like an unusual tool, but really it has its benefits, and we're going to be looking at two different things. This week, we're going to be looking at time as a tool that can help us level set our expectations. The following episode, the following part two, is going to be about time as a tool to help us live our best life, to help us live a virtuous life seeking after wisdom. So, but this week we're talking specifically about how to level set our expectations as we're going through life. As human beings, we have a lot of ideas about how we should live our life, and many of us are just trying to figure things out as we go along. But if we look to some of the people from antiquity that have gone before us and have lived out a virtuous life as viewed by others, and have left behind some amazing resources for us, we can learn from them, figure things out for ourselves in terms of, you know, kind of pour these things over around in our mind and go, all right, how can I apply some of this stuff to my life to see things pan out in a much better way for me, help me become the best version of myself as possible. Well, we're going to open up with a quote from Marcus Aurelius. This comes from Marcus Aurelius's Meditations. This is specifically the annotated edition by Robin Waterfield. We've read from it previously, and this is not a paid endorsement for this book. I just think it's a marvelous book, and one that anyone who is interested in pursuing wisdom and unpacking the philosophy of Stoicism, this is an essential book. He writes in notebook number 4, meditation number 43, "Time is a river of events, and its current is strong. No sooner does something heave into view than it's swept away, and something else is carried past instead, only to be swept away." It's a very short reflection. And as I've mentioned before, I'm pretty sure, Marcus Aurelius didn't write this as a thing for us to be consumed. You know, this is what he didn't intend this for publication. We'll put it that way. This was effectively his private journal, his time of reflecting and meditating on different ideas and trying to work these things out into his life and processing through them. Well, he tells himself, and by extension us, that time really should be viewed as a raging river. The minute something comes into view, it's then swept away and is then replaced by something else. I think about one thing that this makes me think about is my daughter and I love to have these different conversations about pop culture, right? And she loves to talk about things that are trendy. You know, she will share trends that are going on at school, whether it's trendy music, the latest dance craze in TikTok, or whatever it may be. She loves to particularly goad me on my music preferences. Of course, my music preferences date a lot further back than hers. And it's not even in the realm of her thoughts that this music was at one time trendy. So I think about it in recent memory. One thing comes to mind. The duet between Paul McCartney and Kanye West. Now, I recall that when Twitter was aflame about this duet, and Reddit and all the other forums out there, how many of the young, more ignorant people, and when I say ignorant, I mean ignorant about music history, were saying things like, oh my gosh, this is going to really help Paul McCartney's career take off because, oh my gosh, he did a duet with Kanye West. Paul McCartney's going to be the next thing. When really it's kind of the other way around. Paul McCartney has had a very long, prolific career. Of course, starting with the Beatles, and that career alone was just mind-boggling in terms of the way that they changed pop culture and the society in general. But how quickly it has changed over to, you know, younger generations who are a little bit more ignorant of some of these icons from the past are approaching this. We're like, well, we don't know who that is. Should we care? Think about that dynamic. Now, think about how quickly in our lifetime, us as older people, how quickly even someone who is still around, still existing, how their music career has kind of drifted into, is slowly drifting towards obscurity. Now, I'm not saying that Paul McCartney's music anytime soon is going to be drifting to obscurity because he's on kind of the level of an icon. But think a little bit more intimately with the things that you and I create. I think about my history as a musician. I've been a musician for the majority of my life, really. And some of my earlier music, my solo projects, some of the first bands that I've been in, I really don't think that very many of my friends, except for people who are extremely close to me, really even remember much about these things, remember the names of the bands that I were in, let alone remember anything about the albums we released or some of the concerts that we put on. And I, you know, think about this a little bit further. Now, think about as we die and all our friends and fans or people that have followed us in our creations, at some point they're going to die too, and those things that we created are going to pass into oblivion. Think about time as a river, that it's constantly flowing and is constantly going to be bringing new things in and ushering old things out. The Stoics like to think about time in this regard, into helping put things into perspective. We have this folly of an idea that we've got all the time in the world to do whatever we want. Especially as we're younger, we feel invincible. We feel like time is on our side, like we've got an infinite supply of it. In fact, quite often, we treat time like it's an infinite supply. And that we're going to have a legacy, and it's going to live on beyond us. We like to entertain these ideas that maybe someday we'll make it in the music business, or become famous, or become trendy, or become something worth remembering. But the reality is, when you view the whole of time, the Stoics encourage us to constantly view our life, the things that we do, and even the existence around us, the people around us, the events around us, in the whole of time. Like, we like to think that that what we create is going to live on in infamy, or live on as a permanent fixture in our culture, when the reality is that most of us, the vast majority of situations, we're going to fall into a level of obscurity. We're going to reach a point where, you know, hundreds of thousands of years from now, even dozens of years after our passing, most of what we've ever done, said, and thought are going to be left to obscurity. Forever forgotten, buried with us, buried with our friends or our fans or our followers. And that might seem like a thing that would cause us despair, but that's not really the Stoics' intent. The Stoic philosophers of old, they didn't teach us that life is short and soon you're going to die for the sake of causing despair. Rather, it's level setting of expectations, knowing that your time is short here, and these empires of ours that we are so keen on building, making a name for ourselves, making a legacy for ourselves, even those too are going to be short-lived. So it's really about a challenge to reorientate ourselves, to adjust our thinking and reprioritize our life and align our life with things that are of more noble and higher value, not for ourselves, but for humanity as a whole. We're going to be continuing this conversation. I want to keep these videos, try and keep them short. You can find more exposition on this if you go out to STOLACE.com/meditations. Look for meditation number 3 on this subject. I believe the title is On the Shortness of Life, Part 1, Level Setting Expectations. Next week, we're going to be talking about how this becomes a path to virtuous living. And so that's where the hope kind of comes in. Things using time as a tool to help steer us and guide us towards a fruitful, effective, and truly happy life. So thanks for tuning in. Be sure to head out to STØLACE.com/meditations for more meditations like this, and to get some resources to help you live out your better life. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to hit the like and subscribe button if you want to stay in the know about when new music and releases and other resources in Stoicism and philosophy become available. Thank you so much. I appreciate you, and have a fantastic day. Bye now.